In this training video for Dragonfly 3, we're going to look at the Move tool and the tool for 3D registration. These tools are useful for when you've got multiple image channels loaded in your scene, and you may want to manipulate one channel and move it, either translating it or rotating it, possibly to be superimposed with another image channel. In the scene we're looking at here, we have two image channels loaded. They're both scans of the same object, and one is scanned at 40 kV and the other is scanned at 150 keV. Both scans are of an object of mineral grains encased in an epoxy, and they're both scanned on an X-ray diversa system. However, at this point they're not perfectly superimposed, and one might want to do superimposition before continuing the analysis. In order to properly superimpose them, you can either use the Move tool, which is found here, or you can use the 3D segment 3D registration, which we'll look at in a moment. The Move tool is quite simple. It has only two buttons, one which enters you into the display state where you can displace the currently selected object, and the other is an undo. So I have two objects in my workspace. If I select the 150 keV sample, I can now enter into the display state by clicking this button. And now if I'm in an MPR view, I can translate the currently selected object. If I translate and release the mouse button, you can now see how it's been translated in the 3D scene. I can hit the undo button if I want. So in this way, I can translate up or to the side or down, etc., and I can undo whenever I want. The rotate button also works, or the rotate widget also allows you to rotate the currently selected object with respect to everything else in the scene. I'm going to double click on this view and zoom in. I can translate the center of the rotation by grabbing the bullseye and dragging it somewhere on screen. Now I can grab the other end of the widget and drag to rotate in plane. If I double click again, you can see there's been a rotational offset in the 3D view. So the Move tool allows you to apply this translation and rotation. So if I click the undo button, that will undo the most recent rotation. Now let's introduce just a little bit of rotation, and now we will consider the dataset registration tool. I can come over to my listing of scene elements in my dataset data properties and settings, and I can right click on an object and I can go to dataset registration. Here you have the option of choosing which dataset will be kept fixed and which dataset will be rotated or translated in the registration process. So if I want to try just rotation, I can say just rotation, and I can tell it to apply to start the computation. This will allow me to do a rotation which will move the 40 kilovolt data set in order to register it with the 150 kilovolt data set. You see that there's an initial step, so that is the step size of the coarse search, and then after that optimal step is found, it'll proceed to use smaller steps. You could also simultaneously search for translations to find the optimal transformation to register the mobile data set with respect to the fixed data set. You can also see that the interpolation method for the transformation and interpolation can be either set to linear or nearest neighbor, and the scoring function for the registration can be either set to mutual information or sum of squared differences. That summarizes the behavior of this tool, which allows you to register one data set with another. You see that at this point it's finished the completion and it has rotated the 40 kilovolt data set so that it is now once again superimposed with the 150 kilovolt data set. So that concludes this discussion of both the Move tool and the dataset registration for 3D data registration.